Hi students, in this video we'll discuss about the chapter biomolecules. This chapter is very important and the smallest chapter. From this chapter you'll get totally 6 marks. The total weightage of this chapter is 6 marks. In that you'll get one mark question and one 5 mark question, and the total weightage of this chapter is finally 6 marks. So first you want to know what are the important concepts for exam orientation. So in that, first you want to know the definition of biomolecules. Biomolecules are said to be the complex organic molecules which are present in a living system. So those are said to be biomolecules. Example, you will take carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, nucleic acids, etc. All these are examples of biomolecules. First we want to know what are carbohydrates. So these carbohydrates are optically active polyhydroxy aldehydes or ketones. Optically active polyhydroxy aldehydes are ketones, and those compounds are called, which are those compounds which can yield such type of compounds in the hydrolysis, are called carbohydrates. Example, you will take here glucose, fructose, galactose, and so on. Okay, all these are said to be carbohydrates. These carbohydrates are again classified into 3 important types. So such types are monosaccharides, next second type oligosaccharides, and the third type is polysaccharides. These are the 3 important types of carbohydrates. Monosaccharides cannot give any further carbohydrates on hydrolysis. Okay, they are the simplest carbohydrates which cannot be further hydrolyzed. Example, we will take here glucose and fructose. These 2 are the simplest carbohydrates, and further hydrolysis they do not give any further carbohydrates, so that we can call them as monosaccharides. Next, oligosaccharides. These are the saccharides which can leads to give 2 to 10 saccharides or 2 to 10 monosaccharides. So they can give 2 to 10 monosaccharides on hydrolysis, then those are said to be oligosaccharides. So example, here we will take different types. Okay, so for example, sucrose, we can take sucrose is one of the oligosaccharide which can give 2 monomers or monosaccharides on hydrolysis. It is containing both glucose and fructose. Whenever sucrose undergo hydrolysis, it can give 1 mole of glucose and 1 mole of fructose. Then that is said to be oligosaccharide. Okay, next, finally polysaccharides. Polysaccharides can give more than 10 monomeric or monosaccharides on hydrolysis, then those are said to be polysaccharides. Example, here you can take for polysaccharide starch and glycogen or starch and cellulose. So these are containing more than 10 monosaccharides in its structure. That's why whenever they can undergo hydrolysis, they can give more than 10 monomeric or monosaccharides. So then those are said to be polysaccharides. Okay, that is about the first classification. Next, second classification based on the reducing property. So these are of 2 types. First one is reducing sugars. Reducing sugars are the carbohydrates which reduce Fehling solution and Tollens reagent. They can reduce Fehling solution and Tollens reagent, then those are said to be reducing sugars. Example, we will take glucose, fructose. They can reduce this Fehling solution and Tollens reagent. Second one, non-reducing sugars. Non-reducing sugars does not reduce Fehling solution and Tollens reagent, then those are said to be non-reducing sugars. So example for non-reducing sugars is sucrose. Sucrose neither reduces ferrin solution nor tollens reagent. Then those are said to be non-reducing sugars. Okay. So in your syllabus, you have about the reducing sugar, that is nothing but glucose, about glucose preparation and properties. Now we'll see or we'll discuss about that glucose. Now we'll discuss about one of the most important monosaccharide and which is example of reducing sugar, that is nothing but glucose. So glucose is also known as dextrose because it can rotate the plane polarized light towards right side, and it is also known as grape sugar because it is present, major of the glucose is present only in the grapes, so that we can also call them as grape sugar. Next, glucose is also known as aldohexose because its functional group is aldehyde. Hexose indicates the presence of 6 carbon atoms. So that's why it is known as aldohexose. Now we want to discuss about this glucose preparations. There are two important preparations of glucose. First preparation is from cane sugar, or we can also call it as sucrose, because cane sugar contains the oligosaccharide, that is nothing but sucrose. When this sucrose undergo hydrolysis, sucrose formula C12H22O11, when it undergo hydrolysis in presence of an acid, this sucrose can be converted into monomers or monosaccharides, that is C6H12O6 plus C6H12O6. So one is glucose, other one is fructose. Both are obtained. Okay, so now when sucrose undergo hydrolysis in presence of an acid, it can be converted into glucose and fructose. Finally, we have prepared glucose. This is one of the method to prepare glucose. Okay, next, another method is from starch. Starch is the major source of glucose. When starch undergoes boiling with water in presence of dilute H2SO4 at 393 Kelvin's temperature and 223 atmospheric pressure, the starch can be converted into glucose. Starch formula C6H10O5N. So it is a polysaccharide. When it undergo hydrolysis with n moles of water in presence of an acid at 393 Kelvin's temperature and 223 atmospheric pressure, all these monomeric units present in the starch undergo hydrolysis, converts into monosaccharides. The starch is made up of n number of glucose molecules. When n number of glucose molecules combine together, it can be converted into a polysaccharide. Okay, this polysaccharide starch contain n number of glucose. It can be converted into n number of C6H12O6. This is nothing but glucose. N moles of glucose is obtained. So this is the best method to prepare glucose from starch. Okay, now we'll see about its properties. So there is a chance to ask about these properties either for 1 mark or 2 marks. Listen carefully. So how to find out the presence of 6 carbon atoms present in a glucose? That can be using by a test, that is heating of glucose in presence of HI. First one is heating of glucose in presence of hydrogen iodide and phosphorus. When glucose formula C6H12O6. When it undergo heating with hydrogen iodide and red phosphorus. Okay, here we are heating this mixture. So this glucose structure can be converted into another important molecule, which is nothing but N-hexane. N indicates normal, hex indicates 6 carbon atoms. All the 6 carbon atoms are present in the form of a normal chain. Then it can be converted into CH3, CH2 taken 4. That means this kind of CH2 is totally present in 4. So instead of writing particularly 4 times, I have written here 4 bond CH3. The total number of carbons present here 1 plus 4, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. So all the 6 are present in a straight chain. Then it is said to be N-hexane. This N-hexane indicates that all the 6 carbon atoms are present in a glucose is present in a straight chain. So all the 6 carbons present in straight chain. Okay, now we want to see next test, that is test for C double bond O compound or CHO group. Presence of carbonyl group can be easily find by treating this glucose with the hydroxyl amine. I am taking here glucose structure, the same C6H12O6. We can also write in another form, that is CHO, CHOH taken 4 and CH2OH. So even here you can see the presence of 6 carbons, 12 hydrogens and 6 oxygens. Okay, now it is undergoing reaction with hydroxyl amine, that is NH2OH. We can also write NH2OH in this form, hydroxyl amine. When this NH2OH react with this oxygen of aldehyde, react with H2, eliminates as H2O. Now this CH make a double bond with NOH, then we will get CH double bond NOH, CHOH taken 4 and CH2OH. This is called glucose oxime. The form glucose oxime confirms that this glucose is containing one of the carbonyl group, that is C double bond O group is present. It may be ketone or aldehyde. Next one, test for OH group. I already told you this glucose is a polyhydroxy compound. Polyhydroxy means many OH groups are present. Now we want to find out and we have to confirm how many OH groups are present in this glucose. For that we are conducting a test which is known as acetylation. So for this test I am taking here CHO glucose, CHO, CHOH taken 4 and CH2OH. Here 4 and here 1, totally 5 OH groups are present. Now we want to confirm by making it to undergo reaction with acetic anhydride, that is CH3, C double bond O, O, C double bond O, CH3. This is called acetic anhydride. When this acetic anhydride react with this glucose, it loses some acid and finally we will get a compound. Exactly, just imagine here the bond involves in breakage. Okay, then this hydrogen reacts with this O, CH3COO, and converts into CH3COOH. Acid is removed. To this oxygen, C double bond O CH3 part is added. Then we will get CHO. You just leave this and write here CH2O C double bond O. To this O, C double bond O CH3 is added. Plus what is removed? CH3 C double bond O O is added by hydrogen. Acetic acid is released. In the same manner, even at this carbon atom, totally 4 OH groups are there. So in that, 4 hydrogens reacted with 4 moles of CH3COO and released as 5 moles of totally CH3COOH. Okay, here totally 5 moles released. Further take here 5 moles of acetic anhydride and here CHO is added by C double bond O CH3 and it is present totally in 4 moles. Okay, and this is finally confirms pentaacetyl glucose. Okay, penta glucose pentaacetate. This is called glucose pentaacetate. The form glucose pentaacetate confirms that glucose contain totally 5 OH groups or 5 hydroxyl groups. Okay, next, fourth test. So that fourth test is to confirm the presence of aldehydic group. Test for aldehyde group. To test the presence of aldehydic group, we are making a test which is nothing but bromine water test. So this bromine water test is used to confirm the presence of aldehydic group. Okay, so that take your glucose CHO, CHOH taken 4, CH2OH. Now this glucose water undergo reaction, so glucose react with the bromine water. Okay, bromine water is one of the oxidizing agent which is having the property to convert aldehyde group into acid. Only it can convert aldehyde group into acid. So here aldehyde group is present. This can be oxidized by bromine water, converts to COOH acid, and we will get here CHOH taken 4 and CH2OH. This is called gluconic acid. The formed gluconic acid confirms the presence of aldehyde group present in glucose. And finally, the last test. Okay, so presence of primary alcoholic group present in glucose. So primary alcoholic group, that means totally 5 hydroxy groups are present, but all the 5 hydroxy groups are not primary, only one is primary. To confirm that presence of one primary hydroxyl group, we are making one more test. This is used to test for primary hydroxy group or primary alcoholic group. So primary alcoholic group can be conducted by the test oxidation. Okay, this test of oxidation of glucose can easily confirms the presence of primary alcoholic group. So that we are taking here glucose structure CHO, CHOH taken 4 and CH2OH. When this glucose undergo oxidation, strong oxidizing agent like concentrated HNO3. In presence of concentrated HNO3, it can act as a strong oxidizing agent which can oxidizes both aldehyde group and primary alcoholic group into acids. Then it converts to COOH, CHOH taken 4 and COOH. This is called saccharic acid. The formed saccharic acid confirms that the glucose contain one of the primary alcoholic group. Okay, so this oxidation test is used to confirm the presence of primary alcoholic group. That is about the properties of glucose. Any one property can be asked for 2 marks. So what is the test used to confirm the presence of 6 carbon atoms in a straight chain in glucose? That is nothing but reaction with hydrogenated and phosphorus. What is the test used to confirm the presence of aldehyde group? That is bromine water test. So like that, they last for 2 marks. Very important. And preparation of glucose is also very important for 2 marks. Now we'll move on to the next topic. Now we'll see about the Havard structures of glucose. Very important for 2 marks. Very, very important for 2 marks. Okay, if you know the closed structure of glucose or fructose, based on that we will write Havard structures. So here you can see it is a 6-membered cyclic ring. So first atom is oxygen, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. 6 atoms are present. So write first 6-membered heterocyclic ring. Okay, in this pyrano structure, whatever the groups are present on right side, these are the groups present on right side. So consider it as first one, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon and fifth carbon. So the groups present on the right side, right on the below the plane of this carbons. This is above plane, this is below plane. This is above plane, below. Above the plane, below the plane. Above the plane, below the plane. Above the plane, below the plane. So the groups present on right side, right here below the plane. That is OH is present on right side, that's why it is alpha D glucopyranose. And first carbon, if OH is present on right side, that is called alpha. So that OH is present on right side, right here. Here OH is present on right side, right here. And here H and here OH. Leave about the fifth carbon. Now left side groups you have to write above the plane. Left side on first carbon, H is present right here. Here H is present right here. And here OH is present right here, and on the fourth carbon H is present, whereas at fifth carbon atom hydrogen and CH2OH is present. So always you want to write whether it is alpha or beta glucopyranose. Always you want to write CH2OH on the fifth carbon above the plate. So I am writing here CH2OH above the plate, hydrogen here. So this is about the Havard structure of alpha D plus glucopyranose. Very important for 2 marks. In the same manner, we can also write a Havard structure for beta D glucopyranose. Same here, 6-membered cyclic ring is there. right six-membered heterocyclic ring. Above the plane, below the plane, mention the groups, whatever the groups present on right side. This is, as I already told you, at first carbon atom, if OH is present on left side, that is called beta. Now it is beta. So right side groups right below the plane. H, OH, H, OH. Leave about the fifth carbon atom. Okay. Now left side groups right above the plane. OH, here H, and here OH, and here H. At fifth carbon, CH2OH should be written above the plane, H should be written below the plane. So this is about the beta D plus glucopyranose, which is very important for 2 marks. Next one, this one. For fructose also we want to write. Fructose is always said to be furanose but not the pyranose, because it has only 5 atoms in a cyclic ring. That is first atom, second, third, fourth, and the fifth one is oxygen. So because of having 5-membered cyclic ring, it is said to be furanose. Oxygen here and 5 atoms we will write. So above the plane, below the plane, mention 2 bonds. This is alpha, because OH on the first carbon atom is present on right side. So write all the right side groups on the below the plane. OH, H, OH. Leave about this one. So at fourth carbon atom, CH2OH and H is present. Always we want to write CH2OH above the plane. So H will be below the plane. Now write left side group on above the plane. So that is here CH2OH, and here OH, and here H. Like this we will write. This is alpha D fructofuranose. Now in the same manner we can also write beta D fructofuranose. This is homework for you. Okay. Write and send me the habit structure of beta D fructofuranose. So among these 4 structures, one is compulsory for 2 marks. That is compulsory for 2 marks. Habit structures are very important. And write and send me the habit structure of beta D fructofuranose. So that is about this carbohydrates, which are examples of biomolecules. So up to carbohydrates I have discussed in this class. About proteins and nucleic acids we will discuss in next class. Thank you.